Okay, made it to the top, at least of this section. So now we got to take a trail that goes that way. It's going to go right to the downhill of Mont Césaire. And here's a little sign. Got some rock art here. And a little rest stop. So that's it. This trail is the last stretch. There's going to be a little bit of climbing. Shouldn't be too bad, but just charging up my GoPro and we'll get that last section done and give it a call today.
So when you get to the top of that climb, it brings you right around here. There's this cool trail called Césaire, and it goes towards Mont Césaire. We actually end up starting right around there. It's got a little bit of a downhill, and then just some kind of like shallow climbs, a few kind of smaller punchy climbs. It's really not that bad, and it's got some pretty good sections. I had fun on this trail. I thought it was a pretty good trail. So I think Césaire is it's a nice trail to get out to the kind of keystone trail here, which would be Mont Plante. So I think Césaire and Mont Plante are pretty good trails. Even though Monte Azules is a little bit of a climb, I would say it's this is definitely worth it. So if I ever came back here, I'd definitely be doing this set of trails here for sure. So yeah, let's go check out Césaire. I knew these things were coming up. Whoa! Shit! Oh. So even though we went down a bit, we're still on the mountaintop. You know, which is kind of cool. It's like a mountain within a mountain. So, starts to climb now. Really friendly little climb here. My legs are putting out like 2 watts. Like just breathing on pedals. Oh man, I am done. Boulder.
Don't mind me, this is totally rideable. I'm spent. So, just trying to conserve energy. But, yeah, this is technical but doable. It's not that steep. So, just coming up to the top of the mountain here. Woo! Another massive boulder there. Here's the, almost there. Baby steps. Size that boulder. It's insane. Yeah, this is the hardest trail ride I've ever done. Absolutely. Finally. Oh man. Oh man. Oh bro. My goodness. Oh. Alright. I'm not gonna do the tour. Forget it. We're going down. So, whoa. Mont Plante. It's probably gonna be the saddest downhill ever, but let me charge my GoPro up.
Okay, so finally made it to the Mont Plante trailhead here. And there's a little loop you can do toward the summit, but there's no way I was gonna do it. If it's any good, just comment down below, tell us all what it's all about. But it just looks like a little kind of roundabout that goes around the mountain peak of Mont Plante. So I was completely done for the day. I wanted to get out of the bush, and my ride out was gonna be this run that I had no idea how good it was gonna be. Called Mont Plante. So without further ado, let's go and check that one out.
All right, let's get this done. Oh. barely have enough energy to stand on the pedals. Whoa! Damn that! Appreciate it more. Had more energy. Picked a way to end it. Okay, a little jump there. This is insane. This is an insane epic trail. Holy crap. Whoa. Wow, I did not know this was gonna be like a burnout trail like that. Low trail. Crazy. To enjoy it. Gary said that. Just repeating shit. So I'll drop there. Things worth it. Holy shit. That boulder. A little jump there. A few minor pebbly sections. Insane. This is probably one of the most epic trails I've ever ridden. It's kind of got like flow tech. There. For anybody just tuning in, I just spent the whole day riding, so a trail like this, normally I'd like trying to hammer a ride a little more aggressively, but not gonna happen. Barely stand up on the bike.
So just a little note, we're basically right around down here. And if you notice now, this is kind of blocked off as private property. Normally you would take this run back to get back to the parking lot, but it's kind of cool because the good news is they built a connector trail that kind of goes right here in between these homes. This little forest section, then it comes out on the road. So then you just come out on the road, and then they got a cordoned off section just for bikes. So you can just take the road back kind of all the way here and then make your way back to the parking lot that way.
So you gotta hang it right. And this looks like a new corridor they made to get out to the street. So once you're back on the road, to get back to the parking lot, it's about kind of downhill mostly. So say, this is a long exit trail. Look at the road, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. Here we go. Right on. Yeah, that's what I thought. That was it right there. That's where your exit is. They got these little things here too, so you can kind of be safe. All right, so listen, that was by far, that was the gnarliest trail ride I've ever done. It was the most difficult trail ride I've ever done. I probably went a little bit too late, so that's a good lesson. Don't go too late if you're planning a big ride. But yeah, that's Val-David. That's pretty much most of the good stuff. That last trail, Mont Plante, was like, it's mind-blowing. I'd come out just for that trail. Can you get some, this is not where you're supposed to go. I just wanted to get a shot of That's it. So that was Mont Césaire. We were up there, came all the way down. It's crazy. So yeah, I'm beat. I'm gonna make it back to the parking lot. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this was helpful. Hopefully the safety tips were helpful too. A little bit of lesson learning in there. And so thanks for watching and subscribing. Leave a comment, all that good stuff. And for people who are showing gratitude by small donations, it's just so appreciated. So appreciated. I can't even thank you enough. It's freaking awesome. So yeah, I'm spent. I'm done. Gonna shut her off. See you out in the trails. Cruising. Like a little bike super highway. There you go. Right on. So one of the neat things about Val-David is that there's this thing called Saint-Denis. So it's a trail that's like a super long trail that goes all the way through the Laurentians, and it kind of has like a major stop here in Val-David. So this part's paved, but it's mostly gravel. And it gets a lot of traffic, and a lot of people every year make the trip to try it out. So this is a pretty epic gravel trail. They have all along the way they have little like stops like this. So yeah, it's super scenic. A lot of people do like big long trips on this trail, and yeah. It's kind of a cool little spot. Rapids here. I'm not sure if you can swim. Gotta check that out. Ah, damn. No swimming. Oh well. This restaurant looks pretty good. Might give that one a try later. So this is kind of the heart of the strip here. It's a couple little cafes and little bistros. There's a bike shop right here too. Have any mechanical issues, so that's pretty cool. And it's pretty quaint, similar to Chelsea, Quebec, about the same size. So yeah, I think it's worth taking a stop after for a prairie ride. It's a couple nice places to check out and a few restaurants that are worth checking out. A little pump track here. It's pretty cool. They got some skinnies and a little teeter. Hey, did you like this video? Most importantly, did you find it helpful and informative? If you did, so I set up a PayPal link where you can show support and gratitude in the form of a small donation of your choosing. That is going to help grow the channel. It'll help pay for some expenses, and it's going to allow me to continue to make these long form videos of various trail networks across Quebec and Ontario. Absolutely no obligation, of course. If you're feeling it, go for it. And if you do, I thank you, and it's very much appreciated. Also, don't forget to hit like. That helps the videos with the YouTube algorithm. And leave a comment. Love comments. Subscribe. The usual routine. All that good stuff. Appreciate it. Thanks for watching the videos. See you out there in the trails. Until next time.